whatever that is on.
Are actually pretty new to marine science. Probably in the last 10 years or so, we've seen this sort of evolution of technology that's allowed for very small and very easy to use aircraft that make it really simple for researchers to make use of them. Here at our facility, we have over 30 different aircraft, and they are of a fixed wing type, or they're all the kind of a small helicopter type, often with multiple propellers. We were able to develop the ability to fabricate components for drones. And so that allows us to engineer our own airframes and make our own drones, like this one right here. The fixed wing aircraft are generally useful in situations where we want to cover a larger area and we want to try and map things out. We work a lot with multi-copter drones, essentially small helicopters with multiple propellers. In this case, this aircraft here, we use a lot to study the movements of whales. We're able to fly over them, measure them, and to be able to follow their behaviors to look at how they're foraging or how they're socializing.
This one was one that we built just a few months ago. It's based on some microcopter electronics that come from Germany. So it started out its life as a kit, essentially used the electronics off it and then ditched the rest of it. The basic kit as it came actually just had aluminum, square aluminum boom, so you get a lot of vibration through that, which translates through the electronics. The props that come with it are just a fixed plastic reinforced plop. So these are actually a carbon fiber. They're a balsa core carbon fiber blade, which means they're very stiff and efficient. They're also a lot quieter when the aircraft is flying, and with the ability to be able to fold them up so they take up less space. And then this mechanism here actually allows the booms to be able to fold down, so we can get the entire aircraft to very quickly fold down into a small cylinder, put it in the pally case, and when we want to fly, we literally just fold the booms out, fold the props out, put the battery in, and we're ready to fly.
Sample on the ground at resolutions that we haven't been able to do before. So when we normally do our flights, we're sampling at about 2.5 centimeters per pixel in the imagery. So essentially being able to see, you know, things on the ground that are a couple of inches. And that's something that remote sensing from space or from airplanes, it just can't be done. We can go and make our measurements now essentially whenever we want, as long as it's not a deluge of rain, as long as it's not blowing 25 knots of wind, we can go out and we can do our science. Because we work in a marine context, there's challenges for being able to launch and recover the drones. In some cases, we work from land that's adjacent to the coastal or marine area that we're interested in. And in that case, we're able to actually launch and recover right from the beach. We also are unique in that we have a facility that's dedicated to the use of drones in marine science and conservation. There's actually no other facility like that I know of in the US. And so in that sense, we're actually leaders.